listening, FHS Red Raiders. Today is September 20th, 2019, and welcome to the FHSTV Week in Review. I am your host, Elliot Bean, and I'm with
your boy DC.
And this is the Red Raider Review. For our first news of the day, it's coming from a high school down in Virginia, and the students were punished for using racial comments and slurs at a party off campus. In result of this, their football game was canceled, and the team they were playing against had to play another team for the week.
You know, racism, it's a topic that's never gonna get old. At the end of the day, it's all over the place. Doesn't matter what age, what color. But, you know, on other parts of the world, actually, most now, camouflage vaping is now being discovered in a form of a hoodie. So it's replacing the device, and it's overtaking a lot of schools. It's, you know, it's difficult for teachers to see because it's a form of clothing.
Yeah.
So it's like you're not going to see a student literally take out a pen or something and just start hitting it there. It could be in the form of a string, I'm assuming. It's unfortunate, you know, that you try to save kids every day, but every day for every solution you make, a new problem is started, and it's not the way.
These companies are getting really creative and
really creative. It's just, for the money.
It's becoming a dilemma, honestly.
Yes, it is.
But with our next topic, this is a more cheerful topic where a Chick-fil-A worker saved a customer's life.
Good old Chick-fil-A.
This just shows how great the customer service is. The woman, she was a trained nurse, but I don't know how she got a job at Chick-fil-A. Obviously, a nursing gig didn't work out. But there was a customer choking in the parking lot, and she saw that, ran out of the restaurant, and used CPR before the ambulance came and was able to save the customer's life.
I think Chick-fil-A is just doing a lot of great things at this point.
Yeah,
they're doing a little too much.
Everyone's just loving it.
They're too good.
Honestly, just boosting the popularity and how much people come to the restaurant.
But from positive news back to negative, unfortunate for all of us New England fans or Patriots fans, we got ourselves, for those that don't know, we acquired one of the greatest wide receivers in NFL history in the name of Antonio Brown. A little backstory for him. Former receiver for the Steelers, went to Oakland, things didn't work out there, recently signed with the Patriots. Once he signed though,
that's when
a woman comes out, I believe it's his, was his trainer?
Yeah, it was his past trainer.
Yeah, his trainer comes out and accused him of sexual assault.
Mm-hmm.
Now this obviously not only sparked a lot of buzz for the NFL, but majorly for him because he just got out of a huge dilemma with the Raiders.
Yeah.
And so his name has been a huge topic of discussion for the whole NFL. And it's sad.
Yeah.
It's sad seeing a good player have to go down because he has been accused of sexual assault.
Mm-hmm.
And also, Nike has just dropped him.
Yeah.
And it's just sad.
But at least he gets to play this week.
And he got to play last time as well.
Mm-hmm.
He did. And
It looks like the NFL is on his side.
Yeah, it does look like the NFL is on his side. And so, Bill Belichick, it also looks like he's also on his side,
mm-hmm.
as well as Tom Brady. But, you know, despite the accusations, I think he's still gonna go far.
Yeah, I think he'll prevail over these.
Very far, very far.
Accusations. And more sad news is that the Bahamas have been hit with another hurricane, Hurricane Humberto, again in the past 2 weeks. Thankfully, Bermuda, though, has not been hit and just escaped the hurricane's path. And hurricane season is becoming deadlier and deadlier each year. And people got to become more aware of this. And it's just sad seeing all this damage being done.
You know, after one huge hurricane,
mm-hmm.
say goodbye to one, say hello to the next in a matter of, 2 weeks?
Yeah.
You can't
adapt to it.
You really can't.
You got to be lucky and help you survive. Or get out of there, honestly.
Think of all the help those people need, man.
Yeah.
But it ain't all bad because up here, we getting some good weather, and most importantly, great weather for our football game against, what's the people's name? I don't even know. All I see is L. Yeah. All I see is a huge L.
Supporting these babies right here. Red Raiders, baby.
You already know. The only colors we know are red, gray, black. And that's it. It's going to be hot. It's going to be very sunny. Mm-hmm. Don't get too hyped, though. Bring a sweater in the night.
It does get chilly.
It does get chilly in the night. But in the days, don't be afraid to go out and enjoy your weekend. It's going to be in the 80s. Definitely, like I said, really sunny. But please, attend the game. Go to the game. Show our team the support you got. I know a lot of you like to hype up the games. Yeah. I know a lot of you guys like to show up and then brag about it the next day and talk about what touchdowns you scored, you know, the yards you got. So just show up, support, and show whoever these people are that on our turf, you don't want to show up. Not on our turf. Not this city.
And make sure you wear your red tonight. Red out. Everyone's going to be wearing red. You don't want to be the odd one wearing white. So wear red. And continuing with the school, it's today's lunch menu. It's the normal lunch foods like pizza, deli sandwiches, chicken patties, stuff like that. But the favorite today, new, is the cheesesteak, which would be in its own line, where you just go in line and you can make your own, or you can customize your own cheesesteak.
A cheesesteak. Y'all heard that. A cheesesteak. We ain't had that before. Yeah. We didn't have that, and now we do. So yeah. Enjoy it.
And you know the lines are going to be long, so if you really want that cheesesteak, get a lunch early.
I know there's going to be a lot of arguments for cutting, but, you know, be respectful. Just be in the line. Wait your turn. I get it. At the end of the day, it's just a cheesesteak. It's going to come back. It's going to come back. Don't worry about it. But it does sound really good.
Yeah, it does sound really good.
You know,
yeah.
We're starting to get really creative up in this cafeteria, innovative up in here. We're doing a lot of good stuff.
Especially with some strawberry milk. That would smack.
Definitely. Sticking to our last segment here. Also, including school, it's the school store. I love this topic because I just love clothes. I love buying merch, and I know you love buying merch too. Everyone here likes repping Raiders.
I'm repping the merch.
Everyone here likes repping the red, the gray, and the black. You can get literally anything from a hoodie to a hat to a sweatshirt to a tee. I don't even know what you want. You want a cup? They're probably going to have cups. Keychains. They're probably going to have a minifigure of the Red Raider. We're going to get all of that up in here. Get it. It's all cheap. You already know. You want to look for it. It's in front of the gym, next to the auditorium.
In the front entrance, to your right, in the lobbies. It's self-explanatory.
Usually open during all lunches, so, you know, after you enjoy your Philly cheesesteak, head on over to the store and be like, you know what? After a good Philly cheesesteak, I'm feeling like buying me a sweater.
I'm
going to wear that sweater, and then I'm going to wear it to the game where we're going to beat Tense. I don't even know what. And they gonna lose, all right? And then after that, the next week or whatever week it's open, you go back and be like, you know what? For that game, I wore this sweater, but this time I want to wear that type of shirt. And we gonna go and beat them too. And we gonna beat anyone that comes on our turf. You already know the vibes, man.
Yeah. And like he said, wear red. Get a red hoodie. If you don't have red already, you know what to do. Go to the store. And that is all the topics we have for you for this week, and thank you all for watching. I'm going to pass it out to Tiara with the Spotlight Teacher of the Week.
Go T!
I'm Tiara, and I'm here with Miss Searle, the guiding learning teacher.
Hello. Hi.
And we're just gonna be asking her some questions about like what she does here and like why she does it. What's your role here?
My role is a special education teacher. Mm-hmm. I work with students with intellectual disabilities and students with autism.
How long have you been doing this?
This is my second year at Fitchburg High. I love it. This is my dream job, and I'm so glad that I landed at the high school level and be able to make such a difference and really impact these kids.
How did your career begin?
My career began, I did my undergrad at Worcester State, in elementary, and then I couldn't find an elementary job right away. Mm-hmm. So I became a one-on-one ABA para, which is working with autistic students. And I worked there all throughout grad school. And then I got my severe disabilities license, and now I'm here.
How long did that take you?
All of my schooling took about 6.5 years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
How do you deal with the day-to-day struggles?
I take them one at a time. It's kind of like how a police officer handles random things thrown at them. Mm-hmm. You kind of live in the moment, and you know, a student can have a behavior at any moment, so you just have to be on your toes.
And always prepared for it.
Always be prepared, always have a backup plan. If I ever need to leave the room for meetings, you know, just being prepared is huge.
Right. What made you want to work with these special group of kids?
So, like I said, I originally wanted to do, you know, gen ed, mm-hmm. Like typical students, elementary. But when I took that ABA job as a para, I really fell in love with students with special needs and making a difference. Mm-hmm. I also nannied a boy who had severe autism. So
how was that?
Awesome. You know, and I was able to help their family cope with a lot of things. And so I learned a lot about that. And then I just fell in love with special ed.
What's your favorite thing working here with the kids?
Seeing the students master something that they've been working on forever, whether it be, you know, properly washing their hands or finally mastering, you know, a set of words that they've been studying, or you know, anything really, like something that they've been working on for a long time. I have a student who struggles in the lunch line, and you know, the other day she waited in the lunch line for a good 4 minutes.
Oh, wow.
Which is crazy, because you know, at the beginning of the year and last year, we just have to scoot her to the front.
Thank you for answering my questions. I hope you keep enjoying what you're doing with the kids, and I hope it gets even better.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
No problem.
Hi, I'm Jaden Rodriguez. I'm a freshman here at FHS. And so far, my experience here has been pretty good. There's a lot of friendly people in the halls. A lot of people have helped me find my classes because I'm always late most of the time. But it's alright. And I would say that it's hard to find a place to sit at lunch, but if you have, like, if you're there first and you have somebody to help you find it, you're pretty good. One of the biggest struggles here is like getting to class, because the halls are so crowded all the time. But if you go through the back stairs, which nobody goes through, it's pretty good. I'm Jaden Rodriguez, and this was my fresh take.
Hi, I'm Tyler Timothy. I'm in ninth grade. This is Fitchburg High School. My experience so far has been pretty great, especially balancing sports and school. At first it started a little bit hard, but it got really good. And the people here, they're pretty cool. So I just had to put myself into the group pretty much, and if everything's all right so far. I'm just very happy to be here so far, and I couldn't wish for a better experience. Yeah, I'm Tyrell, this is my fresh take.
These 4 years at FHS have really done quite a bit for me. I haven't really changed a lot as like a person, but it's really helped me come into my own, it's like to know who I am and what I want to do. I've had quite a few great memories, met a lot of great people throughout these years, and they'll last for me forever. What I want to do, this school has definitely helped me figure that out. And I've taken a few journalism classes, and I know that's what I want to do with the rest of my life. This is Gabriel Velez, and that was my senior diary.
Hey, my name is Mr. Link. I'm here at FHS. We're at the lunch room, and today we're gonna do this week's question of the week. I'm here with
Maureen.
Double R.
Okay, and we're gonna see if she's got a little bit of knowledge. See if she can answer this question. Okay, what is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink? You got 5 seconds to answer the question. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I don't know.
Five. No clue?
No.
She don't know what it
okay,
is.
Okay, if it's a riddle,
maybe next
I don't
time.
Know it.
Maybe
if
next
it's a riddle,
time.
I don't know it. Here.
I had to step up my game here, really go get the big dog. I'm here with Mr. D, Coach D. Y'all already know, you get in trouble enough, you go see this guy. But he's gonna give his crack at the question of the week. So Mr. D,
yeah.
What is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink?
Lives if it's fed and dies if you give it a drink?
Dies if you give it a drink.
Mr. Raph.
That's a good question. That's a good answer, I should say. That is
definitely
true.
Mr. Raph.
That's your answer, that's what
that's
you're going
my
with?
Answer, man. I'm going with it.
It's a good answer, but it's not the correct answer. But
all
thank
man,
you.
Better luck next week.
Mr. Link here. I'm outside now. You know, we got the first few wrong, so now we're trying to find somebody who could actually get it right. So I'm here with?
Precious.
Precious.
My last name, too?
Last name, please.
Fuentes.
All right. Precious. Got a question for you. Let's see if you can get it right.
All right.
What is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink?
What lives if it is fed and dies when you give it a drink?
Yep, you got 5 seconds.
Oh, a fish.
Oh, close. I thought you were gonna say
what is it?
That's all right.
Hey.
I thought she was gonna say it too. That's all right. Hey, we're gonna keep going until we find somebody who can get this right. Mr. Link. Still here in the cafeteria. We're having a hard time here trying to find people that know the answer to these questions. I'm starting to really question what we're teaching these kids in this school. But I have another guest. What's your name?
Samari.
Samari.
Velasquez.
Okay, let's see how good your knowledge is.
Yeah.
Okay. What is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink?
Fire.
We got one. We got one. And for you getting that correct, gift card.
Thank you.
Good job. We got one. It's the Link in the cafeteria still with the Red Raider question of the week. I'm here with
Joel.
Joel.
Arias Mateo.
Okay. Ready to answer the question?
Mm-hmm.
All right. What is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink?
Wait, say it again?
What is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink? You got 5 seconds to answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Joel, my man. Hey, good try, my man.
Thank you.
On to the next one. Back for another attempt. We're here with the so-called star quarterback. What's your name, my man?
Montgomery Graham.
Montgomery Graham. KTV. Wins on the football field. Let me see if my man can get the question right here in the cafeteria. So Montgomery, what is it that lives if it is fed and dies if you give it a drink?
Whoa.
5 seconds.
I don't know.
That's your answer?
Yeah.
He don't know. So since he's the last one of the day, I'll go ahead and tell him the answer. It's fire, bro.
Out of here.
I want to thank all my guests. We're here at FHS Cafeteria. Question of the week, Red Raider. Hey, be ready because I'm going to be in the halls and I'm going to find you and see if you got this knowledge.
Hi, my name is Dahlia Howell and this is my senior diary. So over the last 4 years, my experience at Fitchburg High actually has been a really good one. Fitchburg High has like a really bad rep. And people think that this is not a good school or like we're ghetto, but Fitchburg has provided me with like a lot of programs that has helped me towards my future career, such as Project Healthcare and Step Up. By joining these two programs, I have created a lot of relationship, like lifelong relationships and lessons that would help me through college. So I hope to be attending one of the state schools in Massachusetts, and I feel that by the programs that I joined, it's gonna help me in my career path. I wanna be a surgeon, so I would go to state school first.
My name is Dali Howell, and this has been my senior diary.
This year, my mom got me the perfect bag for back to school.
These colorful binders help me stay organized.
These headphones are just what I need for studying.
These new sneakers are just what I need for the new year.
This jacket is a real must-have.
My parents got me the skateboard I wanted. It's pretty cool.
These scissors really come in handy in art class.
These colored pencils, too.
These new socks? They can be a real lifesaver.
I finally got my own phone to stay in touch with my mom.